A close-up look at animal welfare issues is supported by animalwelfareissues.com.
You are watching A Close-Up Look at Animal Welfare Issues with your host, writer, speaker, and advocate, Tina Evangelista-Eppenstein. This show is supported in part by animalwelfareissues.com, spotlighting issues around the globe. Check out the latest TV shows, articles, podcasts, and more. That's animalwelfareissues.com. Now here's your host, Tina, in 3, 2, 1.
When Chekhov saw the long winter, he saw a winter bleak and dark and bereft of hope. Yet we know that winter is just another step in the cycle of life. But standing here among the people of Punxsutawney and basking in the warmth of their hearths and hearts, I couldn't imagine a better fate than a long and lustrous winter. From Punxsutawney, it's Phil Connors. So long.
Nice speech, Phil. Very nice.
Thank you.
Thanks. How was that for you two?
Hey, man. You touched me.
Thanks, Larry.
Thank you.
Everybody, this is Tina Evangelista-Eppenstein. You were watching a clip from Groundhog Day, the movie, with Bill Murray and Andy McDowell. And Groundhog Day 2021 is coming up next week. I'm assuming you heard, but there won't be any participation right there. They're going to do it virtually this year for Punxsutawney Phil to CVC's The Shadow. And I want you to stay tuned because I have Phyllis the Groundhog here, and we're going to see if she's going to see her shadow, if we're going to have 6 more weeks of winter, if we're going to have spring coming early. And I'm rooting for spring. I got Quiz Kid here. We're going to see how much he knows about Groundhog Day.
Wow.
But hey, Quiz Kid, how you doing?
I'm hanging in there. Yeah. Getting ready for spring, I hope.
Yeah. How you doing with, well, how you been doing since New Year's, the last time I saw you?
I'm good. Hanging, just, you know, doing what I have to do.
How was your New Year's? I mean, with everything going on, I mean, with the COVID and the cold weather.
Right.
I mean,
things are getting back open, back to normal, if you want to call it normal. You know, hitting the movies and going out to eat, you know, open the place up, get things going. No more sitting behind shields and everything else, you know.
I think they're going to keep the shields up, to be honest with you, but I've been getting out too, you know, but you got to be smart in your movements, but getting a little burned out on COVID. I mean, it's real, don't get me wrong, but I just think there's so much that the public can take, huh?
It's, yeah, but they have a lot of treatments now. They know what this is and what this does. Now, there's some variants to different things that are coming out, but their treatments are better, so less people are, thank God, not passing away from it, and less people are, they're not suffering longer with it. They're less people on ventilators, less people, but a lot of people have it because testing has gotten so good to pick it up, and people are getting tested. If you go to, say, a CVS or something, you're sitting in line behind people are getting tested, and you're waiting for your medicines. It's like you have a long wait. You're just sitting there.
Yeah,
it's like, and you're thinking, you know, they don't.
It
have,
should be set up a little bit differently.
It
so
should
people
be done
at their
a different
medicines
place
through the drive-through. Have you ever been to Punxsutawney to see Groundhog Day? I mean, to actually go there?
No, I watched it on TV, but I've never been there. Usually it's
I watched it on PCN.
Oh, you
and,
did?
And it's on my bucket list. I want to go there.
All right.
Yeah. In the movie, Bill Murray says that people are hicks. I just think it's a fun time. It's something to do. I mean, they stay up all night long groundhog.
I think we, as with this COVID stuff, have been trapped in Groundhog Day. If you think it's more relevant now than anything, if you want to know what Groundhog Day, wake up
this
each day
Groundhog
when things are closed and you're going through drive-thrus where you used to walk in. So this has been Groundhog Day. So
they said that. Yeah, I just read that.
Oh, you
that
did?
We're living Groundhog Day over and over again because we just can't get out of this.
Are you getting out? Are you getting out now?
Yeah, absolutely. I'm getting my dog out. Oh, talking about dogs. You have a cat. Now, do I want to ask again, what's your cat's name?
I don't know.
Okay. We're not going to do that again.
Not going to go.
We did that last time. Does your cat get ear infections?
I would say no.
Well, my dog Birdie does, and his chronic condition, and he's constantly getting them, and he was just at the vet again last week. And I don't know if anybody out there, if their dog gets chronic ear infections, and it's usually the dogs with the longer ears, a lot of the hair in the ears. I mean, he's constantly getting groomed. But the vet says he has allergies.
Okay.
And he's been congested now for nearly every day for months. And he just got treated not too long ago for an ear infection. Now he has it in both ears, and now he's on antibiotics. He's on some steroids, which, wow, I mean, I've had a dog on steroids before. And Brody's been on steroids before, but my one dog, he was on two packs, and he just went, he couldn't settle down.
Right.
You know.
Don't they eat more and drink more?
Yeah, they can eat more, they drink more, and they have to go to the bathroom more.
Okay.
So,
well,
I mean, you have to stay on top of that, and they may have accidents, but it's really frustrating. He has to go back for a follow-up appointment to see what's going on. Now, she did blood work on him, the vet.
How'd that come out?
And he's fine. She wanted to see if there's any underlying problem because he's constantly getting him, and he's, you know, just really congested. But he's got year-round allergies like a person. I just feel so bad for him.
Some of that, I think, is the dry heat now with everybody, you know, with the colder
weather. Well,
dry
heat, but then it's spring allergies, summer allergies, fall allergies. So he just has it year-round. He loves the water. He loves to dive under the water, you know, to get a ball. But, you know, I mean, I let him one time last year. And because I knew he was going to the vet, and because he loves that, he loves to go out in the water, he loves to swim. He's got a vest. He's got three legs, so he's got a vest. But
does he swim in a circle?
It's just frustrating.
Does he swim in a circle?
No.
Oh, okay.
No, he does not. He has a vest and he swims straight. So, how much do you know about groundhogs or Groundhog Day?
Groundhogs. Okay. Groundhogs are part of the marmot family. They're one of the largest
rodents.
Would
you look that up?
Yeah, but I've also...
Because I looked that up,
I know the Pennsylvania Dutch now call them the whistle pig. Cause
they call them the what?
A whistle pig. Whistle pig.
Oh, yeah, yeah. That's
that's their warning. When they and that's their warning. It's sort of like prairie dogs have a yip. They have a whistle. And it's a loud whistle. If you ever walk down a fence row and startle a groundhog before he runs in his hole, I mean, it's ear-piercing. It's pretty good.
Yeah, groundhogs, people generally just look at them as rats or something, or rodents. And, I mean, Punxsutawney Phil is celebrated, and so is Phil's here. Do you know when Groundhog Day started?
No, I don't.
1887, but that was in the United States, here in Pennsylvania, in Punxsutawney. But do you know where it originated?
It sounds probably German. I don't know.
Yeah.
Oh, it is? Oh,
yeah.
Wow.
And it came over here, you know, and it's, you know, the Dutch.
Right.
Who do it. And now this is known just not in the United States. I mean, Punxsutawney Phil is the most famous mascot for Groundhog Day.
Right.
I mean, there's a lot here in Pennsylvania alone, other mascots. And most events have been canceled, but there's one in Dover, PA, and York, PA.
Isn't there a Pagoda Patty or something? Or
I have no idea. I didn't read anything in Pagoda Patty, what they're going to do. Most people are doing it virtually, but the one in Dover and York, they're doing it.
Okay.
But they don't have a real groundhog. It's probably kind of like my Phyllis here. But they're doing that, and people have to just wear masks. I think because it gathers small crowds. And I went to the one in Lancaster, and I forgot if it's something, Orphy or something.
I remember that show. I remember seeing that show.
Yeah, but that's been canceled too. And, you know, a lot of people, you know, not ton of people like Punxsutawney Phil, where thousands travel from around the world to see Punxsutawney.
So if they cancel it and he doesn't come out of his hole and he doesn't see his shadow because he didn't come out of his hole, does that mean we're good for spring?
Wait, say again?
Okay, in other words, are they going to actually have him come out? Or are they just canceling?
They're going to do it there.
Oh, okay.
It's just going to be virtual.
Oh, all right.
And then they'll announce it. I mean, nobody will be there. It's just like we would be seeing it on TV with no crowds.
I got you.
And so, I mean, they decide beforehand.
Right.
And did you know, do you think that the inner circle, and these are the men that
take care of
Phil, do you think they've been right most of the time or wrong most of the time?
I think they have a pretty good track record, even for a lot of this is all, you know, suspicion and guess.
Well, from what I read, they were 40% right. Their record.
They're probably better than any weathermen around here because they haven't been getting anything right.
I mean, the Farmer's Almanac, they're claiming they get 80 to 85% weather correct. And it realistically, they said they analyzed that, and that's more like 50% of the time.
Right, so they're right on track.
But I want to quiz you, since you're a quiz kid, okay?
Wow. Okay.
I want to see what you know about groundhogs. Okay, let's see. Hold on. I'm getting there. Groundhogs build their homes underground.
Right.
And what are these called? Are they called condos, townhomes, cribs, or burrows?
I go with burrows. Burrows.
Yes.
Okay.
They are burrows. I guess they stay underground. I mean, they hibernate. And then they come out to see, I guess, what the weather's like. And then don't they start mating then?
What they do is, they supposedly Groundhog Day, the male comes out and supposedly goes, checks the other burrows if they're not under snow, and finds out where the females are. So he knows right what house to knock on when it's breeding time, when they do come out of hibernation. You know, so they're, it's weird. When they come out of hibernation, they're like drunk, just like a bear. Everything shuts down on them. So they're, I mean, they're wandering around like they're drunk because nothing, their muscles atrophy over the winter.
They're drunk.
They're drunk, yeah. And you never know, they could be still celebrating from New Year. But their burrows, you always have a back burrow, and that's why the farmers don't like them, because when their cattle, if their cattle walk out and fall in a groundhog hole, the back burrow is a straight down hole, and they end up, cattle end up breaking their leg, and the farmer has to put the cattle down.
Yeah. I can see that. I mean,
they are destructive. You know, their burrows can go 40 feet parallel. They're really good at digging. They said even a groundhog can actually take out some 300 to 600 pounds of dirt cleaning out his burrow. Move that much dirt.
600 pounds?
Yeah, underneath. That's because the burrows are 40 feet long and they're...
How do they do that, though? I mean, okay, so they're digging a burrow. Where does this all this dirt...
They kick a lot of dirt out, but they actually move dirt from underneath once they get the burrows and packing it down.
What was that movie? The other movie Bill Murray was in. Was that a groundhog, too? That one where... He's trying to get this groundhog in this movie.
Oh, that's Caddyshack. That's a golfer, which is sort of...
Oh, what is it?
Golfer.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Those are the ones that burrow right under the ground. They don't...
Okay. Which is not another name for a groundhog. A woodchuck, a ground squirrel, a whistle pig, or a gopher?
Gopher.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But, well... Yeah.
Gopher is a smaller version of a groundhog, but it's not, they're not the size of a groundhog. Groundhog can be anywhere from 10 to 13 pounds. The males are bigger than the females as far as the groundhogs go. And that's unusual because in the birds, like a bald eagle, the female of a bird is usually bigger than the male. So it's completely opposite with a groundhog. The male's bigger than the female.
What's a baby groundhog called? Let me see if you know this one. Is it called a chuckling? A kit or a cub?
It made chuckling, I'm guessing. Am I right?
Partially. They're called a chuckling, a kit, and a cub.
Okay.
All of those names.
A kit is baby fox. They have a kit. That's what they call a group of, I know that, but I didn't think it was associated with a groundhog. Learn something new every day. So they're all three.
They're all three.
Okay.
Yeah, I have a couple more questions
then.
But Valentine's Day is coming up.
Yep.
And are you taking your whatever your spouse, your girlfriend, whoever you can take her out?
Maybe.
Maybe. Wow. You didn't hear it here. but did you know that, you know, Valentine's Day is on the 14th of February, but it's also known as Pet Theft Awareness Day. Have you ever had a pet stolen from you?
Yes.
You have?
Yes, I have.
Wow, what happened?
I had racing pigeons when I was younger, and I had somebody break in and steal the racing pigeons. And when they came, they obviously took them, and when they came back, the bands that identify them were cut off, and they... pulled the feathers out of their wings, but they don't realize once the feathers came back in, the birds flew back to my house. So
you got them back.
I got them back, but I no longer could race them because they cut the identification off of them. So they were just used as breeders, you know.
But racing pigeons know how to go home.
Yeah.
Now, I've had a pet run away as my dad babysat him, but I never had a pet stolen.
It's a weird feeling, believe me. It's just like somebody's, you know, it's devastating because, you know, it's just a pet, you know.
And I mean, I've seen on social media people are looking for their pets. And one woman in Brooklyn, someone stole her dog as she was walking him. It was off leash, and right. They were allowed off leash, and someone just grabbed the dog. She went around hunting for that dog. 2 days, she found her dog. Some man had him, and she stole him back. And she went to the police after she stole him back, told him the story, and it all checked out. And she's not in trouble for stealing back her own dog. Right. And the man was mad at her, ran after her car, and it was slamming on the right. car. And
I would have backed the car up over.
She doesn't think that he knew that the dog was stolen. He's 15 years old, so the dog's back though. So
that's good.
I mean, I'd do the same thing.
Somebody would have to make arrangements, burial arrangements for themselves if they stole one of my pets. That's the way goes. You know, you don't have kids, you have pets. Your pets are like your kids, and if you want,
pets are my kids.
Yeah,
so but for Pet Theft Awareness Day, I want to show you a quick clip. Here's some tips so your pet doesn't get stolen. Yeah, I just want to thank Last Chance for Animals for making that video. You just really want to be careful. You know, these days people are stealing pets, so just really, really keep an eye on your pet. And, you know, they suggest keeping your cats indoors. I know some people don't believe in that. But that's your best chance at keeping your cat safe. And talking about cats, did you know there, Quiz Kid, that it's National Cat Month? Coming up in February.
Wow. No,
so are you going to do anything special for...
I don't know. I mean, I think I'm going to, but I don't know.
Okay, you don't know.
So I want to do something special for him. But just one more thing with the stolen pets. People have to be aware if they live out in the country or even now in the city that there are a lot of hawks around, okay?
There's a lot of what?
A lot of hawks. There's bald eagles in the area. Okay, there's coyotes now in the rural area. So if you put your pet out on a leash, on a run,
they
can't escape. And if you leave your dog out, especially your smaller dogs like Yorkies and Chihuahuas, they're primed to be picked off by an eagle or a hawk. They're actually, especially some of these Yorkies are so small, you know, the mini minis.
It's happened here. I think is it Birdsboro or Douglasville?
Right,
where
it took that one and dropped it like 4 miles away.
And then there was another one, the same thing.
Right, and the eagles are back right now, and they're rebuilding their nest, and they're going to be on eggs soon. So I just keep in mind, like, your pet does, you don't stop watching your pet after you open and leave him out. You go out with him. That's the best thing. Let him do his business and then bring him back in. You know, and if you're, like, it just got to be careful. There's other... And you could say that my pet was stolen, but no, it wasn't. Here it was picked off by a wild animal, and you don't even know it.
I know. People have seen that happen. I think one of them in Douglasville or Birdsboro, one of them, and just a few years ago, they actually saw it happen.
Can you imagine that?
And they thought that the animal would be dead, but it was found, and both were okay. I mean, you know, I had a duck one time, a Pekin duck, a white duck, you know, with the orange... Bill.
The Affleck.
And it was my pet for a little while. And one time I was out with him, and he ran over to me on my lap. I was out with my dogs and my duck, Snowy. He came running over to me and sat in my lap, and he's looking up at the sky. And it's like, what? I look, and it's like, there was a hawk.
Oh, yeah.
And it's like, he wanted to be safe, so. But I put him on a pond, you know,
right.
at a farm, you know, where he belonged out in the country then, you know. He was just too big.
Yeah.
You know, but I loved him. Did you know that February 3rd is Date Your Dog Night?
Date Your Dog. Yeah. You can take that two ways. You know what I mean? There's probably
two ways.
Yeah.
I know one way. What do you mean two ways?
You'll figure it out later.
Date your dog. Okay. It's just take time with your dog. And I think the 22nd or 3rd is walk your dog. And there's a dog biscuit day this month. I mean, there's all kind of days in the month of February. It's dental month. You want to make sure you watch out for your pet's teeth. My dog had oral melanoma, had part of his jaw removed, but got it in the early stages, both times. So you want to be careful with that. But I want to find out if we're going to have an early spring, okay? So what I'm going to do, we're going to find out here if Phyllis sees her shadow. What do you think? What do you predict?
It's pretty bright in here, but I don't know. I mean,
let me see. Now, we'll make sure. I mean, let's see. Let's see if this works. Hold on. It doesn't work.
I'm sure she's live.
Well, it's not working.
Well, she's in. She's all right.
Wait. Let's see, Phyllis, do you see your shadow?
Actually, she can't because of the sunglasses, so you're good to go.
I know. All right, Phyllis, you can't see your shadow, and that's the ticket. That's all that matters. So we're going to have an early spring, everybody. You heard it here first.
She's all right, too, so she doesn't have COVID.
Let's
all
see
right.
See how good she's at predicting this, and with the sunglasses on, she can't see it. Okay, you done?
She's
Thank
done.
Thank you. So we're going to have an early spring, everybody. Oh, I'm thrilled with it. And we got, what was that, a couple minutes left?
5 minutes.
Five
left.
Minutes. But early spring, everybody, I'm so thrilled. I'm ready for spring, although I don't know what weather station, no, the Farmer's Almanac, I think, someone said that we're supposed to have a blizzard the second week of February.
Is that an ice cream dish?
Now, I looked
or
it up. I found no activity happening in our area. But you know, along the East Coast, we're supposed to have a blizzard 1 to 2 feet. No, we're not, because Phyllis says we're having an early spring. I got another question for you. If you're skiing down a slope.
Right.
Okay. And you're going at a good pace. And you have a bear behind you, running after you.
A bear behind me or a bear behind? You got to be...
A bear
behind,
is behind you.
Oh, got you.
Okay.
Well, I was worried there.
What do you do? Let's watch this first, and then you can answer.
Go ahead.
Mama.
Wow. Oh, here we go. Okay, I see it. There we go.
There's multiple clips.
This isn't his pet. This is definitely...
What?
This is definitely a bear chasing a skier.
Yes, it's legit.
Okay.
This happened in Romania.
Oh.
It just happened this past weekend. It's not fake. And people were videotaping this and screaming. And screaming at the...
So he doesn't know it.
No, he did not know it.
Wow.
And there's this myth for some reason that bears can't run downhill.
Yeah.
Why do they think that?
Because they're back heavy.
But But they can.
Well, obviously, you know.
I mean, this is legitimate. This was in Romania at a ski resort, and he didn't know there was a bear behind him, and they had to check it out. But multiple people took videotapes of this happening, and they were screaming in the one video to go faster, to go faster, and they said, God forbid, don't look back.
Right, but what happened at the end there?
Huh?
What happened at the very end?
No, it's a good question. I was just going to tell you that.
Sorry.
The skier is okay. What he did, and he did a really smart move. He took his backpack that he had, and he threw it off and threw it over and away from himself. And so it distracted the bear. And so the bear went to that backpack, and so the skier got to safety.
Okay.
Now, they said they saw a bear, I think the other year, same area, same resort in Romania. It's like the largest slope. And we're running out of time here, but the largest slope, and they got that bear, and they relocated, and that's what they want to do with this bear.
Okay.
But, you know, that's a bit scary to have a bear coming up behind you. I think I would freak out. Now, there was a woman the other year, 2016, she faked this bear being behind her as she's snowboarding.
Right.
It was proven to be fake. It's like, oh, my God, I almost got eaten by a bear.
The weird thing about that video is bears usually hibernate. There's snow on the ground unless they did snow early. You know what I mean? Where it was actually warm enough that bears didn't hibernate. They hibernate over the winter. They're just like groundhogs. So for that bear to even be out in that kind
of cold. Must be hungry, right?
Well, yeah.
And that's why he's running after the man.
Yeah.
Don't they typically leave people alone?
Yeah, unless he smelt food in the backpack. But that's when he threw the backpack, if the food was in there or anything he had in edible.
I don't know what he had in there. All I know, it did work, though.
Okay.
And I'm running out of time. I got a minute left. Right. And I just want to say to Punxsutawney Phil, the prognosticator of all prognosticators, you know.
Wear sunglasses.
We hope you say early spring. Phil has said it here first. But I want to end this show. With Punxsutawney Phil, I want to thank Quiz Kid for
thank you for having
getting,
me.
I think, most of the questions right. So thank you. But I want to leave it with Punxsutawney Phil. And happy Groundhog Day, everybody.
Here he is.
When Chekhov saw the long winter, he saw a winter bleak and dark and bereft of hope. Yet we know that winter is just another step in the cycle of life. But standing here among the people of Punxsutawney, and basking in the warmth of their hearths and hearts, I couldn't imagine a better fate than a long and lustrous winter. From Punxsutawney, it's Phil Connor.
Hear ye, hear ye, hear ye. Now this second day of February 2nd, 2020, 02-02-2020, the 134th annual trek of the Punxsutawney Groundhog Club. Punxsutawney Phil, the seer of seers, prognosticator of all prognosticators, was awakened from his burrow to the cheers of thousands upon thousands of his faithful followers from around the world. In Groundhog Ease, Phil directed the inner circle to his prediction scroll, which reads, "It's a Phil fantastic day in these beautiful woods, thousands and thousands in the Knob neighborhood. You faithful followers are the best, it's true. You, who wouldn't want neighbors just like you? Now my forecast on a day that's a palindrome will cause some to cheer and some to moan. So do I hope you think it's neighborly, for there is no shadow of me. Spring will be early, it's a certainty.
It's early spring, ladies and gentlemen.